Mitchell.
Yeah, they're a little bit higher. Who doesn't know of American Eagle and who doesn't love the clothes? You know, they're always like great quality clothes that are awesome. And I mean, especially on the show, as my character Emily, I've worn a bunch of stuff from American Eagle. So it's only natural and I love it. It's comfortable, it's great. I mean, it's stuff that I wear in my own life and I think it's cool that my character wears it and I do too. And yeah, our stylist Mandy was super excited as well when I told her. She was like, yay, you know, we wear this all the time. I'm like, I know, Mandy, I read the labels. So it was really, really fun. And I mean, it's comfortable and it's me. And yeah, it's a very natural fit. I love American Eagle. I feel like they have great quality pieces. I mean, their jeans, I have a bunch of them, and they're always really comfortable, and they look great, and they're affordable, and, you know, their new styles, they have millions of styles. And I mean, especially working on Pretty Little Liars and getting to play a character, she also has a bunch of that stuff in her wardrobe, so it's great. It's just very suitable, I mean, especially for the demographic that we're at and everything. It's very fun and it's fresh, and, you know, I love the stuff that she has, that my character has in her wardrobe, and yeah, I have the same stuff too, so it's great. This campaign is really, really cool, and I love it because it's showcasing different people with different occupations, and it's giving you a glimpse into their lives. And you know, they came into my home. It wasn't a set home, it was my own place, and you know, they showed things that I do on a daily basis. One of them being, you know, I love going to the flower market and picking flowers on a Sunday, and we did that today. And it shows how I wear the clothes in my life. I feel it's important because when you walk into a store, you might see how they put, you know, the clothes on a mannequin, or you know, the things that they accessorize the clothes with. But when you go in there, I can choose a piece from all of the different sections and make my own outfit and personalize it. So I think that's really great. And you can see how I wear it, you can see how somebody else wears it, and you know, you can just make it to match your style. And I think that's really important. So you're not looking at an ad that's, you know, somebody else, and you're getting to know each and every one of us and things that we like and how we wear it in our real lives. And I think that's really cool. And because I'm a chameleon of switching up shoes throughout the day, these are my go-to jeans that I can kind of wear up with everything. I would describe my personal style as being ever-changing. I can't just give you one word for that because I feel like I'm always evolving in fashion and who I am and discovering new things about myself. And I think with that comes even, you know, my style and what I wear and what I love to wear. So I think there's even some trends that I wore a couple years back that I might not do again. And yeah, ever changing. 5 must-haves that I feel I have to have would be a great corduroy pant, a beautiful top to go with that, just something that you're comfortable and you feel pretty in. A nice pair of winter boots, a great go-to jacket, something that you can wear from day into night, and a cute matching set of mitts and a toque, which is a hat for those that don't know. We call it a toque and I'm sticking to it, so. I think fashion should be fun and not have too many limitations or rules, so wear what you want. How do you dress up jeans? I think you can wear it. Depends, you know, I can wear, these jeans are ripped up, but I'm wearing it with a beautiful top. So this is dressy. I mean, I have even these little heel booties. If I was gonna go out tonight for dinner, I might swap it for heels, but I'd be good to go. I think, you know, with Emily, she's probably a lot more patient than I am, as Shay. So I try and bring some of that characteristic into my own life. There's times when I know that I should be a little bit more patient. And if I were to be playing Emily in my life, then she would definitely be. So that's one of the traits that I really admire about her. When I found out that Mona was A, it was actually the very last day that we started shooting that episode at the read-through. And I was shocked. Mouth dropped, goosebumps. I didn't expect it to be her. I mean, I don't know who I expected it to be, because everybody who I thought it was, it always turned out that there was no possible way it could be them. But the other girls did kind of get it out of the writers months before, so they knew who it was, but I waited until the very end. I like a surprise, so yeah. When Mona was A, I was shocked. The fan reaction was insane. I was actually on a plane to Ireland when the episode aired, so I only saw any of the comments when I got back. And there were a lot of comments that I'd received, and I think most of the fans were very sad about Maya's death and that crying scene that I had at the end of it. It was pretty full out, but I think, you know, the majority of them were actually very shocked that A was Mona. And even though it had been revealed in the books, the way that we did it in the show was slightly different. So, yeah, everybody got a good surprise, even if you had read the books. Our writers are phenomenal, and they are so good at what they do, and their imaginations are out of this world. So some of the things that they have told me that are coming up in this season are crazy. And I know that the fans will not be disappointed. It's only gonna get bigger and better, and I'm very excited for it. Me and the other girls do not fight over clothes. Each of our characters are extremely different in their styles. I love Emily because I think her style, it's very fashion forward. I mean, it's trendy, it's comfortable, and it's a little bit more casual than the other girls, but she's so comfortable in it, and you know, the tops are great. She loves color and great pair of jeans and a nice top, but it's not over the top, you know? Whereas Hannah is like so many accessories and like whatever trend is in, and then Spencer is more of like a classic kind of, a classic look. So she'll be a little bit more preppy. And Aria is all over the place. That's what I say about Aria. She's like vintage and she makes her own clothes. But Emily is, I think, what the majority of girls in my high school at least wore. And it's a great pair of jeans and a nice colorful top. And you know, Emily would definitely rock out this outfit that I'm wearing right now. So it's really cool. My high school was a lot different from Emily's. First and foremost, I didn't have A or somebody who was calling themselves A following me or stalking me or any of those things. So that's great. I also didn't have a set group of girlfriends that, you know, Emily does with each of hers. I kind of was a drifter. So I came into high school and I was friends with one group, and then I'd move over to another group, and just until I found, you know, the friends that I have today. So I moved around a little bit. A must-have for me is music. Music. I always have my iPhone with me. I was gonna say iPod, but now everybody has, well, most people have an iPhone, so I have my iPod on that. And just music, always. It just gets me pumped. So if it's a long day, then I play one of my favorite songs and I'm good to go. Just need a couple minutes and back on it. One of my favorite songs right now that I'm playing is Sia and David Guetta. It's called Titanium. And I've been playing on repeat, so. I might be sick of it after today because I've literally played it like 500 times, but it's my favorite song right now. If I was not an actress, I would probably be a photojournalist. I love traveling and I love taking photos. I mean, if I wasn't that, I mean, I'd probably be a photojournalist along with a food blogger. Go to different places, travel all over the world, and go to great restaurants and blog about it. Amazing. Yeah. I would unwind with a bath, and it's the most relaxing place for me. I play like a record that I have, and I'll just kind of sit there and not think of anything. It's great. It's just, yeah, I'd say with a bath, that's the perfect ending to any day.